Now on Sunrise and streaming on crossroadstoday.com. On Tuesday, Bloomington held another town hall to discuss the incorporation of the community. What residents are saying coming up. And Trump's immunity once again comes into question. We have the details on the new indictment. Plus, what Facebook is saying the Biden administration pressured them to do during the COVID-19 pandemic.
And if you've been loving all that rain we've had the last few days, get a load of this. We've got a nice rainy end to August coming our way for the rest of this week, even into next week. And actually, we've got a couple of showers out there right now. We'll take a look at how much I'm expecting coming up and the weather.
The Calhoun Sand Crabs ready to start up the season versus the Yoakum Bulldogs. That's coming up in sports.
You're watching 25 News Now Sunrise. Good morning, Crossroads, and thank you for starting your day with us. We're halfway through the week.
That's right. It's Wednesday. We are halfway through the week. Only a couple more days till Friday. And guess what else we've got a couple more days? Oh, we've got plenty more days of.
Of rain. But also of the Star Fishing Tournament.
And of the Star Fishing Tournament. That's correct. So if you're going fishing out there for the rest of this week, be careful and please be alert and aware. You're likely to have some more scattered showers and thunderstorms as we go into the rest of this week, even into next week. But if you're tuning in with us this morning right now, you can see we do have lots of showers and thunderstorms out there. And I'm actually going to turn on the lightning just to prove to you that we do have a couple thunderstorms out there. Nothing kind of severe or really heavy. Just right now, kind of some moderate heavy showers out there right now. But looking at kind of zooming in where all of it is right now, you can see we do have a couple starting to enter Victoria County, also some out west as well, and also some are right along our immediate coast as well. But definitely get those umbrellas out and keep them out for the rest of the day because we've got lots more coming today. I've got chances at 70%. And all this rain is actually forming because of this tropical wave that, if you were tuning in with me earlier this week or late last week, this is the tropical wave that was over Florida and it exited the coast entering the Gulf. And it's kind of, you can actually see a little bit of a spin as it kind of enters our coastal areas as we go into later today and also into tomorrow. But most of us are not really seeing too much in terms of rain right now. Most of us are seeing partly cloudy skies and been a very nice and warm, humid morning out there, sitting at 76 degrees here in Victoria, humidity at 97%. No fog expected out there this morning. So if you're seeing your kiddos out the door, make sure to grab them that umbrella because, like I said, it's going to be probably raining somewhere in the morning, but in the afternoon, definitely, I think so. So we're going to take a look at the timing of all that rain and more coming up later on Sunrise. Back to Carolina.
Thank you, Parker. Bloomington hosted a second town hall on Tuesday that discussed the incorporation of Bloomington. At least 100 people were in attendance to discuss the topic. No conclusion was reached, so they'll try to organize a third meeting.
We believe that all of us are supposed to have a voice in this community, and that's what we're making open and asking each and every citizen in our community to have that voice, to speak for what they want, to create the town that we want.
There is no official word on a third meeting to discuss the incorporation of the community. For more of our coverage on Bloomington, come to our website, crossroadstoday.com. Victoria Fire and Police responded to a fire at the Summerstone apartment complex in the 2100 block of Ben Jordan Street at around 3 p.m. Tuesday. Crews found smoke coming out of the roof of one of the units. No one was at home at the time of the fire, and the cause of the fire is still under investigation. FEMA representatives will be at the Palacios Pavilion helping residents this week. That's at the 693 South Bay Boulevard, and representatives will be there from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. Monday through Saturday to help residents impacted by Hurricane Beryl with paperwork and federal assistance. Former President Donald Trump has been indicted once again in his efforts to overturn his 2020 presidential election loss. Special Counsel Jack Smith has filed a new superseding indictment of Donald Trump in connection with a federal January 6th case. This new indictment, handed down by a federal grand jury, follows the Supreme Court's immunity ruling last month that concluded presidents can have broad immunity for official acts. We'll go to Washington for more later. Another story involving former presidential candidate RFK Jr. has surfaced, and it involves a whale. An environmental group is now getting involved with the situation.
A whale of a tale has Robert F. Kennedy Jr. in hot water with environmentalists again. just weeks after he admitted to dumping a dead baby bear in Manhattan.
But I said, let's go put the bear in Central Park and we'll make it look like he got hit by a bike.
Kennedy faces new backlash. The longtime conservationist allegedly sawed the head off a dead whale back in 1994 after it washed up on a Massachusetts beach. Kennedy reportedly cut off the whale's head and then bungee corded it to the roof of the family minivan before driving it across state lines to bring it back to his New York home so he could study the skull. RFK's daughter, Kik Kennedy, originally shared the fishy anecdote more than a decade ago, calling the stunt normal day-to-day stuff. But the story resurfaced in recent days, leading the Center for Biological Diversity Action Fund to call on federal officials to investigate whether Kennedy violated the Marine Mammal Protection Act, saying, "We hope that the NOAA Office of Law Enforcement, at a minimum, is able to ensure that Mr. Kennedy surrenders any and all illegally obtained wildlife that he continues to possess." The Action Fund has publicly supported Vice President Harris in the presidential race. Kennedy recently suspended his campaign, endorsing former President Trump, and now has secured a position on Trump's team.
I've been asked to go onto the transition team and, you know, to help pick the people who will be running the government.
Rhiannon Alley, ABC News, New York.
Mark Zuckerberg says the Biden administration pressured Facebook to censor some COVID-19 content during the pandemic. Zuckerberg said that senior White House officials repeatedly pressured Facebook for months to take down certain COVID-19 content, including humor and satire. Zuckerberg also vowed that the social media giant would push back if it faced such demands again. The White House said in a statement that during the pandemic, the administration encouraged responsible actions and to, quote, protect public health and safety. The first person to enter the U.S. Capitol on January 6, 2021, is headed to prison. On Tuesday, a judge sentenced Michael Sparks to 53 months in prison. A Washington, D.C. jury convicted the Kentucky man of violent entry and disorderly conduct in March. He entered the Capitol through a window another rioter shattered. Prosecutors argued Sparks planned to break the law, as seen through the protective body armor he wore. He also purchased a rifle in the days ahead of the riot. He posted on social media calling for a civil war. Remember to subscribe to our YouTube channel, Crossroads Today. Hit the like button and click that notification bell. The time is now. Let's look at our clock. It is 6:38 on our Wednesday morning. Here's a look at what's coming up on 25 News Now Sunrise. The deadline for a fishing tournament is fast approaching. There's plenty of prizes still up for grabs.
I'm ABC's Perry Russin in Washington. Former President Trump indicted for a second time for his alleged attempts to overturn the 2020 election. We'll tell you what's different this time around. That story coming up.
And also coming up next after the break, coming up in the full forecast, we'll take a look at the timing for the rain for the rest of today. And we'll also take a look at your weather and health forecast. But coming up later on Sunrise, we'll take another look at your marine forecast and everything else that's going on out there in the tropics. Well, good morning, Crossroads. If you're tuning in with us this morning, you look alive in Quarry Road. Another warm and humid one out there. Look at that car. Looks like he's flying down the road, but just because it's a low frame rate. But otherwise, it's another warm and humid one out there right now, sitting at 76 degrees, dew point 1 degree off, bringing your humidity to 98%. So definitely plenty humid out there. You might see a little bit of dew in your windshield. Not really expecting any fog out there because we've got lots of mixing in the atmosphere this morning. In fact, we also got lots of rain out there in the atmosphere this morning as well, because looking at your radar, we got lots of scattered showers and thunderstorms out there. Good news is no severe weather is expected today. Although any stronger storms that develop, you could see maybe gusty winds up to 30 to 40 miles an hour, or maybe some very, very tiny hail. We're talking pea size at the maximum. But other than that, no severe weather. And actually, you do see a special weather statement right here. That is because the National Weather Service issued that for possible tropical funnel class today. And we're not expecting any tornadoes, but given there's a little bit of shear over us with that tropical wave approaching us out of the Gulf, no tropical weather expected either. There might be a little bit of kind of really interesting spectacle of tropical funnel clouds coming out of the clouds today. So send me a picture if you see that today, peacocks@victoriatelevision.com. But looking at your radar for the rest of today, I think shower activity should die down a little bit as we go into the mid-late morning, but more should start developing sometime after noon. I'm thinking sometime after noon or 1 p.m. today before most of it should die off as we go into the evening tonight, and mostly cloudy skies ensue in the background. Because with the clouds today and the rain, highs only again in the upper 80s, some of the low 90s again. And another good news, pollen is going to be nice and low today, mostly moderate as well for some, but UV index, that's going to be very high with a few peaks of sunshine. But But that weather you just saw there, it's going to continue just like that for the rest of this week. So get ready, and we're going to take a look at that in the tropics next. Now here's sports.
All right, everyone, so we're 2 days away from the high school football season starting up. But one team that needs a lot of questions answered are the Calhoun Sandcrafts. They graduated over 20 athletes last season. A year, they went four rounds deep. But they're returning some star power in their starting quarterback and fullback Colton Judd, who, like they said, they'll see a lot of power down in Port Lavaca.
You know, coming back, I mean, we're eager to stay hungry, and we're just trying to keep that same competitiveness we did last year and just hope for the best and try to make a run again.
I feel like we're just as good as last year. I really do. We got a lot of seniors coming back. We got a lot of new kids, though. But I feel like we're just as good.
We've got a lot of holes to fill from last year. We graduated 24 seniors. This time of the year is exciting for kids because they know there's a lot of kids have opportunities to play that didn't get to play last year. So that's what we're trying to do right now is fill those holes.
Calhoun Sandcrabs, they open up the season versus the Yoakum Bulldogs this Friday night. This is Max Williams, 25 News Now Sports.
Thank you, Max. This morning, former President Trump indicted once again. Trump is facing a superseding indictment from special counsel Jack Smith for his alleged efforts to overturn the 2020 election. The updated charges come after the Supreme Court's ruling on presidential immunity.
The new superseding indictment charges former President Trump with the same four crimes as the previous indictment, including conspiracy to defraud the United States, to obstruct the certification of electoral votes on January 6th, and conspiracy against the right to vote and to have one's vote counted. What's different is the charges are now only for what he allegedly did as a candidate for office, not as president, in his alleged attempts to overturn the 2020 election. The changes are in response to the Supreme Court decision on presidential immunity, which ruled a president is entitled at a minimum to a presumptive immunity from prosecution for all his official acts.
These modifications were done to ensure that the Supreme Court's ruling was respected.
Trump calls the new indictment a direct assault on democracy.
Looks like Jack Smith doing more of what he does, which is filing these absurd lawsuits in an effort to influence the election.
The new charges were filed 70 days before the election. Justice Department policy discourages prosecutors from filing federal charges against candidates within 60 days of an election. Trump argues the 60-day window should include early voting, which starts next month in some places. Trump's former White House lawyer Ty Cobb on CNN.
Does this indictment make a clean-cut case that the acts were personal?
I think it does.
What do you think happens from here?
He won't take this seriously until the, final gavel comes down and the jurors come back and say guilty and, he actually gets sentenced. This will be a lot of delaying tactics by his lawyers.
This case is different from Trump's classified documents case that was thrown out after the ruling on presidential immunity. Jack Smith is also overseeing that case and is appealing that decision. Perry Russum, ABC News, Washington.
The deadline for the CCA Star Tournament is approaching, and there's still plenty of prizes still up for grabs. The tournament's director, Bill Kinney, says you don't need a lot of money to enter, and there's no other tournament anywhere that's longer or richer. The tournament started the Saturday before Memorial Day and ends after the Labor Day holiday.
An event. We just want everybody who has any interest in learning about what fishing can provide, not only in terms of, hey, having a fresh fish dinner, but the great fun that Texans enjoy by getting their family and friends together and getting out on the water.
It's important to note you don't need a boat to compete. You can fish off a pier and still win. The Star Tournament Committee is made up of volunteers, and they have several business sponsors, including outdoor sports stores and fishing equipment companies, giving out prizes. Students 17 years old and under are eligible for scholarships. Come to crossroadstoday.com to learn more. There was no jackpot winner for Tuesday's Mega Millions drawing. That means the jackpot for Friday night will grow to an estimated $627 million. No one's won the big prize since June 4th. In fact, just two people have won the Mega Millions this whole year. By this time last year, the jackpot had been hit 8 times. The odds don't change, though. You still have less than a 1 in 300 million chance of winning. And that leads us to your viewer poll. You can scan the QR code right there on your screen to take part. We want to know, have you ever purchased a lottery ticket? All right, another slight change from the last half hour. Let's take a look. 87% of you say, yes, you have. Maybe you're going to buy one today. And 13% of you say, no, you have not. Come to carcrossroadstoday.com/vote to take part in our viewer poll. The time is now 6:47 on our Wednesday morning. Still ahead, celebrating 40 years of a local newscaster.
Well, good morning, Crossroads. I hope you all are enjoying all that rain that we've had the last couple days, because we got lots more still to come our way. In fact, I'm pretty sure you've heard me tell you all that all morning long. But in fact, we've got lots of showers out there right now as we speak. In fact, looking at your radar, we've got lots of it out there. We've got a couple showers and got a couple thunderstorms out there. The good news is it's real weak thunderstorms out there. No severe weather is going to be expected today. I want you to notice that there was a little special weather statement. I'm just going to go back so you can see it. There is a special weather statement right here. I'm going to talk about that here in just a second, because zooming in on where all the rain is, you can see there is a couple showers kind of entering, kind of passing through Victoria County, but it does look like that's starting to die down pretty classic as soon as it enters Victoria. But looking at what that special weather statement is that you just saw there right there, that is a special weather statement issued by the National Weather Service for possible tropical funnel clouds out there this afternoon as we go into later in the morning and also in the afternoon. So not really expecting any tornadoes out there, but we might see like some little kind of fingers kind of coming out of the clouds today. So that'd be a really interesting spectacle, because we got a little bit of shear over us kind of providing a little bit of spin in the atmosphere. So send that to me if you see any of those pictures, or if you get a picture of that, send it to peacocks@victoriatelevision.com. But looking at your marine forecast today, with that special weather statement in place, I would assume y'all know probably not the best day to get down the coast, but I know there's a fishing tournament in place, so waves are going to be pretty smooth out there with your winds 5 to 10 knots and your water still very warm at 88 degrees. Now, looking at the rest of the tropics, so there's now two areas of interest that the National Hurricane Center is watching. It's going to be this shaded area right here and this one right here. Good news is that one's obviously way out there in the central Atlantic, not coming our way, but this one has a 20% chance of development over the next 7 days. And we're also going to watch over the next 2 to 3 weeks, because the Climate Prediction Center is also watching for development over the next 2 to 3 weeks. But we're going to look at that and more, though, later on Sunrise. Back to Carolina.
Thank you, Parker. On Tuesday, we celebrated 40 years of Don Brubaker. Don and his wife, Cecilia, recently sat down with 25 News Now reporter Lupi Zapata to talk more about the past 40 years.
Riverside Stadium holds a lot of fond memories for Don. He tells me he's lost track of how many times he's reported from this ballpark. Don started his career in Victoria 3 years before I was born to a pair of sports lovers. So naturally, like many Victorians, I grew up watching Don get viewers excited about local sports, especially my parents. Now, I could spend hours talking about Don's accomplishments and accolades, but you can go to our website and read about those. I'm going to introduce you to someone who means the world to Don, someone who he says is his biggest cheerleader, and he's her biggest fan.
He's the love of my life. I think he's my, no, he is my soulmate.
Don says he scored when he met his soulmate, Cecilia, back in 1995.
When we met, that's what he looked like. That was a hairdo he had.
They dated for 2 years before Don popped the question.
How long was it before you knew you loved Don?
Let's see, I think I fell in love with him probably a couple of months after we met. Don's very respectful and very gracious, and he's that way to everyone. Yeah. What you see is what you get.
From the moment they met, Cecilia was attracted to Don's involvement in his sports community on and off camera.
Back in the day, he did a lot of runs at Riverside Park. We've done them together, and he always gives back to the community.
He is a local celebrity. He has a lot of fans. My question to you is, are you his biggest fan?
I am. I like to think that I am.
For almost 3 decades, Don and Cecilia have built a life together. In their home, Don has a room showcasing his years of sports reporting, and a picture of Cecilia is front and center.
We had so much fun celebrating Don yesterday. We had a luncheon right here in the studio.
That's right, we did.
We had people from the city, the county, even someone representing Jeannie Morrison.
That's right, and we also had lots of people that used to work here and used to know and speak with Don that was also they were also sending in some absolutely sweet videos. I love that.
It was such a great time celebrating Don. Be sure to go to our Facebook page, Crossroads Today, so you can see all the fun we had.
Absolutely.
All right, well, still to come on Sunrise. News to note before you go. Plans to launch the SpaceX Polaris Dawn mission have been put on hold once again. Plans to launch the SpaceX Polaris Dawn mission have been put on hold once again. This is the second delay in 2 days, but this time the issue is weather. While conditions for Wednesday morning's launch look favorable, the SpaceX team says it has concerns about the weather at the end of the mission when the Dragon capsule splashes down in the seas around Florida. The four-person crew, which is hoping to conduct the first ever spacewalk by private astronauts. Louisiana has become the latest state to ban the teaching of critical race theory in public schools. Republican Governor Jeff Landry signed an executive order Tuesday. Landry says teaching children they are oppressed or are oppressors is wrong and has no place in Louisiana classrooms. Critical race theory recognizes that systemic racism is part of American society. Louisiana joins 17 other states that have passed bills or restrict the teaching of critical race theory. The number of so-called 401k millionaires hit a new record high in the second quarter, Fidelity Investment says. The increase is based off new data released today. It looked at 24 million accounts across 26,000 employer-sponsored plans. As of June, nearly half a million 401k accounts had balances of $1 million or more. The average 401k balance across all participants is about $127,000. That average is up 13% from this time last year. There's still a few weeks left of summer, and you've heard Parker talk about our temperatures and our rain, but it is very hot across much of the nation. Several cities hitting record highs, and tens of millions are under some sort of heat advisory. As we head toward the Labor Day weekend and the unofficial end of summer, the sun is cranking out some extra heat for tens of millions of Americans. The National Weather Service says heat index values from the Midwest to the Mid-Atlantic could reach 115 degrees. Amanda Zorowski did not want to go into politics. She wanted a baby girl. 2 years after a harrowing pregnancy where she was denied an abortion, the Texan has become one of the Democrats' biggest messengers on reproductive rights. Read this story by the Texas Tribune. It's on our website, crossroadstoday.com. And we want to invite you to experience our digital streaming service, Crossroads Today Plus. You can find it on your connected TV through Amazon Fire TV, Roku, Apple TV, Android TV. Just search for Crossroads Today Plus. And we do have time for a final check of our forecast with Parker. And Parker, the Star Tournament is in play. And you've got that beautiful sunrise right over in Port Lavaca.
Yeah, in fact, I don't know if it's in Port Lavaca, but if you're going down there for that tournament going into today or any time for the rest of this week, make sure to bring an umbrella with you. And also, you may not even be the best time to go down there because we've got lots more thunderstorms coming our way for the rest of this week into next week. So make sure to practice that proper lightning safety. But otherwise, right now, if you're tuning in, 81 degrees down there in Port Lavaca, very humid with a dew point 2 degrees off. And we also have some showers and thunderstorms out there, still out there right now this morning. Because looking at your radar, all the shower activity right now is actually focused west of Highway 87. But coming our way in Port Lavaca this afternoon, I'm thinking a high of about 89 degrees with the rain activity going through the morning all the way into about the mid, maybe late afternoon, and 91 in Victoria today, and I'm thinking 92 in Coiro this afternoon. But if you like that rain today, guess what? We've got a whole week of it going into this weekend and next week still to go.
Wow, I've got to get my umbrella ready.
Yep,
and rain
boots,
mosquito spray.
And the mosquitoes, that's right. Definitely. Watch out for those.
All right, well, thank you for joining us. Have a wonderful Wednesday. Follow us on our YouTube channel for all of that Don Brubaker celebration coverage. And join us tonight for 25 News Now at 5, 6, and 10.